The HeyGears Reflex RS Turbo is a resin printer with a fully integrated wash and cure ecosystem designed to make resin printing nearly hands-off. It's aimed at people who want awesome results without the constant tweaking that resin printing can be known for. The HeyGears system is more of a lockdown ecosystem. This is a device that is not necessarily meant for everyone. This is one of my first resin printers. Having a guided hand is super nice. Not having to mess with settings has been really handy, but I can understand how some people are not going to be okay without having control over certain parameters. Some people just want to tinker and be in complete control, and that's perfectly fine. If you want something that has been tailored to give you a great experience, this could be the printer for you. When I pulled this thing out of the box, I immediately realized it wasn't like the other budget printers that I've seen. Everything about it feels engineered and intentional, from the metal frame to the fit and the finish. You can really tell it's built to last. The level of detail that has gone into this ecosystem is quite impressive. It's on par with Apple or Bamboo Lab. The software all interconnects to the printer itself. The washer, the dryer, even the accessories and resin are recognized on the printer itself. HeyGears did send this system out to me for free, but they did not sponsor this video. I'm gonna do my very best to remain non-biased throughout this. So yes, it's a closed ecosystem. That's the trade-off, convenience and reliability over flexibility. The software all interconnects. When you go to print something, you send the file over their cloud network, or if you want, you can use a LAN connection. Once the printer is done printing, you can then send that same slice project to the washer, where it'll automatically program the washer with the correct settings. The system is set up to deliver you the easiest way to print something from start to finish. Easy for a professional environment where there is no time for tinkering. Each system has its own parameters to follow based on the resin that the print was done in. The same goes for the curing system. The washer is a pretty nifty system. It features a very weighted base with a rotating platform and two buckets. You load up one of the buckets with your IPA and you toss your prints in. You then set the bucket on top of the base with its lid locked down, and it goes for a legit spin cycle. I think it does a really excellent job thoroughly washing the print. From here, I honestly just reach in and grab my print. You can stack the buckets, open the air valve on top, and switch open the release. Do not do what I did one night and open the release on the top bucket without checking the bottom bucket's release. I end up spilling IPA everywhere. Onto the curing station. This thing looks amazing and it seems to work really well. It's got a really solid build quality and the interior is incredibly reflective. The first time I opened it up, it kind of tripped me out a little bit. With all those reflective surfaces, it's gonna aid in bouncing that UV light around to help ensure that your print is fully cured. The curing process is also quite quiet. The overall system doesn't add much noise to the workspace. The printer itself also runs fairly quietly. With the HeyGears ecosystem, you are kind of locked into using their resin, which is really going to be a big turnoff for a lot of you out there. I get it, I really do. No one wants to be locked into using a single brand's material. There are way too many things that can go wrong with that. However, I do get why they do it. They are controlling every step of the process to ensure that they can deliver the best results possible. Not everyone wants to tinker with maximizing the print quality of their machines. Right now, I don't have the time to just sit down and tinker with settings. I have a full-time job. I'm a husband, I'm a father of two. Sometimes there just needs to be a plug and play solution that's easy. This is just what that machine has been for me. The level of detail that I have gotten out of these prints have legitimately blown my mind. But keep in mind, I'm new to resin printing for the most part. So please use your own judgment when you look at these prints that I've showed off today. I did say that you're kind of locked into using the HeyGears resin. While watching some of Fauxhammer's videos on the HeyGears printers, he does mention that you technically can use other resin. You will need to find some that are similar to the original HeyGears profile. So again, it's possible, but you'll be leaving this supported ecosystem. The blueprint software is great if you're new to printing. It features one-click slicing where it automatically will repair, orient, add supports, and get it fully ready for you to start printing. The software also allows you to get direct feedback from support within the app if you need it. The iPhone app has been a seamless experience and has made sending the wash and cure profile jobs over super easy. It also has notifications for when the tasks start and finish. And on that note, I did get a notification for a couple failed prints that failed to stick to the bed for some reason. I have to think that when I did switch to resins, I may have forgotten that to select the new resin in the slicer. After re-slicing the project, it ended up working great. It's also worth mentioning that the cleanup and maintenance are straightforward, the vat easily detaches, and a huge thank you to Wham Bam for sending over their resin products. It has made my experience resin printing for the first time a lot better. The printer features an amber screen, which is supposed to help provide sharper details and a longer screen life. But seeing as this is pretty much my first resin printer, I couldn't really tell you if it makes a difference. What I can say though, is that the prints that I've gotten off this machine have been awesome. The printer and accessories arrived well packed with a ton of packing material. Thankfully, my delivery was free of any issues and my packages arrived safely. Inside the printer, you're gonna find some included tools to help get you up and running. HeyGears provided me with a plethora of resins to test out, everything from their more affordable standard modeling resin to their engineering grade high temp and rigid resin. The PAH10 high temp and rigid resin is something that really surprised me. I kinda always thought that the resin prints were rather fragile and weak, but this stuff seems crazy. I printed this carabiner clip and I tried with all my might to pull this thing apart and break it. I couldn't even get it to budge. The next thing I did was clip it to the saddle of my 28-pound mountain bike and lifted it up with the carabiner, and it still didn't budge. Now, this isn't to say that this printer is perfect. There are a few things that I think can be improved. My number one complaint this far is just how inaccurate the estimated print times are. The time differences that I'm talking about are huge. On a print, that could be quoted at 4 hours, but when I actually start it and get it going on the printer, it could be 2.5 hours. This is something that could be fixed in a firmware, so hopefully that's something that they can look into. Now, there is one thing that we really do need to talk about. This is not a cheap machine, or a cheap setup at that matter. The printer, wash, and the cure station are all currently on sale for about $1,846. Given how well this system works together and the level of build quality from these machines, I fully understand why they're asking this price. If you're a professional or a small studio that values reliability and a clean workflow over tinkering, then this system totally makes sense. If you're the kind of maker who loves experimenting and pushing machines to their limits, this machine is probably not for you. This printer isn't for everyone. That's what makes it special. What else is another special video is this one right here. You should definitely go check that out. And before you go, consider stopping by my Patreon for some more behind the scenes looks and some more upcoming videos. This is Adam from the Rad Dad Print Lab, and I'll see you next time.